My word that I was given was the word reassurance. The reassurance the Lord is talking about is a lot of us are like Joseph from the Bible. We're going through stuff or we're in stuff and we're like, Lord, when is this going to stop? Why? This is so not fair. Even though we may not see it, we put on our little grins, or, you know, like I tell Pat all the time, you know, we fake it till we make it and put on our little church hats and all that stuff, you know, all the airs we put on. But inside, in our heart, we actually really are, not, I don't want to say questioning God, but like saying, what's up, Lord? What's going on? And so what the Lord told me is, I am going to show my people, all of you, all my children, I'm going to show up in ways that you didn't expect and quickly, not in another day. He said it's almost like immediate, and I know that he's telling the truth. I know it's the Lord because he's already doing it with me. Even when my attitude is just not even good, I might be just got through being mad or whatever, bummed out about something, and the Lord will show up and he'll just give me a word. And he said, I'm going to reassure you, all of you, my children, I'm going to reassure you when you're sad. I'm going to reassure you when you're mad. I'm going to reassure you when you sin and you repent. I'm going to reassure you that I have received you and that I am not holding it against you when you repent. I'm going to reassure you when you are wondering, how is this going to get paid, or how am I going to have a job, or why is this relationship or these people are not my friends anymore. He says, I'm going to reassure you that I'm going to be I am that I am in your life. I am going to be I am that I am. That means everything and anything that you need, I will be. The Spirit of the Lord is saying, I need you all to need me. I need you to need me. For remember, you are the branches, I am the vine. And apart from me, you can do nothing, says the Lord. I need you to need me, says God. I need you to need me. I need you to need me for everything. I thank you, Lord, for showing me that. I've gotten to a place in my life, I was sharing with Sister Pat a couple of nights ago, or whatever, last time we spoke, that I've gotten to a point in the Lord where I'm learning to actually enjoy being alone with Jesus. That's what it means to get the work that he has for me. And I don't really care if people don't like me or if I don't have any friends. I'm getting to that point, and that makes me dangerous to the kingdom of darkness. It makes any saint dangerous. You hear me? Dangerous. When you can say, I will walk alone. I will do it with just me and Jesus. You are a danger. And we need to also think why we're going through some of the stuff we're going through is because Satan knows that when you get to that point, you're going to be a force to be reckoned with. Because you get to the point where you're like, I don't care. If I perish, I perish. I'm going to live for the Lord, and I will die unto the Lord. You got to get just like that. But God said, the main thing I want you all to get, my children, is reassurance. Remember what my servant is saying. Reassurance, I will be there. I'll be there. I'm not trying to quote Michael Jackson, that's Jesus. But I'll be there. Okay, God, I love you. You're so funny. But think of that song, I'll be there. I'll be there to comfort you. I'll be there. I'll be there. I can't sing. I'm going to try, Lord. Don't do that to me, Jesus. But he says, I'll be there. Okay? And he is. He's so wonderful. He's the lover of your soul. Every last one of you on this phone and everybody that will listen to this beyond this meeting today. Be reassured that God is big, God is great, and there's nothing that you can say or do that will cause him to not love you or bless you or take care of you. There's nothing. Nothing can keep him away from you. No mountains too high, no valleys too low. Okay, Lord, now you just... But people can relate to those songs. But that's how deep his love is, and that's how personable he is with us. Thank you, Father. That's how personable and how interested he is in us. And he loves us, you know, and he enjoys our company. He really does. So that's the word for you guys and for me. I'm a child too. And be reassured, Pat. Be reassured, Jeanette. Be reassured, Lynn. Be reassured, Rashad. Be reassured, Tina. Be reassured, anybody, Lynn. If I forgot anybody, I'm sorry. But be reassured, everyone, that God is going to walk more personal. It's going to be more personal, more close. And it's not going to be because you fasted or because you prayed so much. He said he's just going to do it. He's just going to pull up. He's just going to show up. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. He's just going to show up. He's going to be like, I didn't expect that. God said, expect the unexpected from him. I mean, just expect the unexpected. Blessings is what I hear. When you are just feeling sicker in your body, you feel weak or whatever, expect for that thing to just go. But God said, I'm just going to show up. I'm just going to show up and just start doing stuff. I think that's a part of what Brother Matt was talking about, how God is just going to just start doing things. And just going to see, and I feel that emotional too, because it's like God is like, I'm taking my children and I'm pulling you close. You know how your mom or your dad or grandma or whoever would just say, come here, baby, come here, give me a hug. And they just pull you in and give you that big old bear hug and that kiss on your cheek. God is doing that to his children right now. But woe unto those who are not. God also wants me to speak on that as well. There are going to be a lot of people that are not seeking God. They want nothing to do with him. There's a lot of people that are idolizing people that are well known, like everybody was all bent out of shape about beloved Betty White from the Golden Girls, and she just died. And I was sitting there looking at it, and I remember the show Golden Girls and all of that, and you know, something I used to watch and enjoy, and I've always thought she was a very funny lady. But the Lord interrupted me and he said, but Lynette, this is the thing. These people didn't know me. They didn't receive me. They didn't embrace me. They didn't take a stand for me. And I was like, oh, Lord. I didn't look at it like that. He said, that's why I'm the light. I'm the way, the truth, and the life. I'm going to show you things. Yeah, these people seem really nice, and they are nice, the Lord says, but nice won't get you into heaven. Okay? Nice won't save you. You know, it's giving your heart to the Lord. So God is saying, there's going to be a lot of people, and it's going to be sad because you know that they weren't with him. We can't just like act like, oh, well, they were so nice and they made us laugh. And Lord, surely, no, God said, I said what I said and I meant it. If you do not accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you can neither enter the kingdom of God. You cannot. No man can come to the Father except through Jesus. So it doesn't matter how talented, how beautiful, how handsome, how charismatic, or whatever you think you are in this world. The world loves its own. And yes, there's a loss, but also, too, we need to think about their soul, that when they went into eternity, that they found out that you're not what you thought you were on this earth. You're not, it's a whole new thing. So we need to think about that. People that have left here, they went, they took off, and they died, and they woke up somewhere, and it's a whole rude awakening, you understand? And that's why what Peter was saying, that the thing about going out and ministering and saving souls is so important, because there are a lot of people, they don't have to be celebrities, they don't have to be singers or any of movie stars or any of that, just regular people that thought that things are going to be like this for me. I'm going to heaven, you know, God knows my heart. You guys have all heard that thing before. Well, God knows my heart. We got, you know, God's my homie and all of that. They familiarize. They think that they can make God how they want him
common,
to be.
Common.
And they don't realize that the only way we can get to know him is by submitting to him, denying ourselves, getting into that word, and then, of course, joining some fellowship. You can't make your own path. There's no lone wolves in this. This is a family. And so I just want to wrap it up by saying God always wants us to consider the other thing too, that there are a lot of people that are not ever going to see him, and we may be the only Jesus that some will see. So you better make sure you're behaving yourself and not thinking you're too much and you can't do this. Just like Rashad and everybody was saying, get your eyes off of yourself. Get your eyes off yourself and focus on the Lord and his work, because it's not your work, it's his work, and we're working for him. Right. Remember that. Know your place. We are animated dirt who knows how to respond to the Spirit of the Lord. And we need to remain humble. And I was telling Pat the other day when I was talking to her, I'm starting to really get a taste of this humble pie. It's an acquired taste. Especially when you have been thinking that you was all that. Okay. But anyway, you know, I always got to throw something in there. But anyway, reassurance. I want to leave you with that. Jesus loves all of us. And he says, look out for me. I'm going to be rolling up on you in unexpected ways, all of you. And I'm going to be doing things you didn't expect, because I love you and I want to reassure you. I just want to reassure you that I'm going to be with you every day of this year. In Jesus' name, amen.